Magoos Corner. I'm your host, Trevor Gregg, and we'll be going through round 17, the Division 5 reserves, and also looking at round 18, the last game of the year for this division. First game of the round, we had Elizabeth hosting Rosewater at Agana Park, and Elizabeth, 18-8, 116 to Rosewater, 7-6-48. I know that we sort of picked something to happen, but I didn't think it was going to be by this much. Not a good day at all for Rosewater across the board, so maybe a little bit of soul-searching down there at Rosewater for next week, because they are still currently in the five. They're level peggings with CBC. They're not going to be able, it's not possible for any of that top five to even be remotely close to going out of the five at the moment. Adelaide Lutheran are four games behind at the moment, so it's a bit of a lost cause for them, but you don't want to have a loss like that with a couple of weeks to go leading into the finals. But for Elizabeth, Millwood with four, Tully also got on the streak with four, Eagle and Ferber with three apiece, Cotter with a couple, and best players were Clark, Ferber, Millwood, Shaw and Hall. So very good spread of contributors there on the score sheet for Elizabeth. Rosewater, Ellis and Cooper with the couple, Birch, Bouchin and Page. And the best players were Ellis, McDonald, Page, Gates and Peterson. So not a good day there for Rosewater. Greenacres hosted Blackfriars. It was sort of said that Greenacres, I think they were forfeited last week, so we were thinking that Blackfriars were may get the job done, but to be honest with you, I think Greenacres were going to be a good show for this one. But it was 8-14-62 to Blackfriars 11-8-74. So a day of coulda, woulda, shoulda with the goal scoring for Greenacres. Coombe with three, Bruin with a couple, and Bingos. And the best players were McNera, Bruin, Bingos, Coombe and Clark. For Blackfriars, Hutton, Milne and M. Clark with two each. Gates, Caro, Ormondy, Lee and Hardy, one each. Lee, Hill, Curtis, Gates and Rivet in the best players. The next game was out at Morgan Oval. Polby gave Woody South a decent touch-up, 21-18, 144 to Woody South, two goals straight. Johansson with nine, so just the one off. Curry with three, Dowell with two. Plunkett also kicked a couple with Cox, Barmby, Barris with just the one. Johansson, Winton, Lumsden, Coburn and Dalwood were the best players there for Pulteney. Irvine and O'Regan were goal scorers for Woody South. Goods, both A and N Smith, Dankowitz and Wall Waddle. So another two dads out there. There's been quite a few this year getting in there for Woody South, and it looks like they may have been short on the day also, which is not too flash. I mean, I can't talk, but Adelaide Lutheran hosted CBC, so Battle of the Parklands with our guys down there, and CBC just continue going at 13-19-97 to Adelaide Lutheran 6-6-42. Ludwig and Edmonds were a couple, Hockless and Burford. Ludwig, Hockless, Gray, Lane and Edmonds were the best for Luthies. And for CBC, Hill with four, Nielby with a couple, Nicholson, Threadgold, Mild and a few others also getting in there with one each. Renfrey, Bolter, Nicholson, Tremont and Clark were the best players there for CBC. Last game of the round, this one was a little bit closer. Para Hills hosted Colonel Light Gardens and 11-10-76 to Para Hills 6-6-42. Norris, Button with a couple each there for Para Hills with Jamal and Vandenbrink getting one apiece. Barrett, Button, Thatch, Rowe and Westover were the best players for the Kangaroos. Day with four, Powell with a couple, Smith, Andrews, Perry, Snell and Brown with one each. Day, Bookwell, Mather, Powell and Andrews were the best players there for Colonel Light Garden. So looking at where we sit at the moment, close race when it comes to the leading goal scorers in Division 5 reserves. Ben or Big Matty Primus from CBC is on 41. Alan Casey from Elizabeth is on 36. Timothy Day from Colonel Light Gardens on 34, Brent Hill from CBC with 25, with James O'Regan from Woody South. So it's a very close one at the moment. The game to go, or the race will be on, but I don't suspect that there'll be too much happening. So looking again into next week, CBC host Para Hills. Now, will Ben Primus be able to kick away here? We'll have to have a look, but that'll be in the East Parklands, and I think CBC will be too strong for Para Hills for mine. Rosewater hosts Pulteney. So this is second versus fourth at the present time. So 14 and 3 for Pulteney at the moment, Rosewater 12 and 5 with Elizabeth and CBC. So this will be either a home final or they will be having a tough road into the big stage, Rosewater, if they were to drop this game. But I think Pulteney will be too strong down at Eric Sutton. But I think it's going to be a closer game than what everybody believes, but Pulteney will be too good. Colonel Light Gardens host Elizabeth, Mortlock Park. I think this will just be another one with the top five playing off in the last round of the week. Colonel Light for me, not by much, but they'll get the job done. Woody South host Greenacres at New Vision Oval. Greenacres for me. I think they'll be far too competitive for Woody South. Blackfriars host Adelaide Lutheran. Blackfriars sitting in ninth, Adelaide Lutheran in sixth, can't make the finals. I think Adelaide Lutheran will win at St Dominic's Oval. So it'll be an interesting way to have a look at it next week with the 1-1 versus 3-2 and 4 to see how those last four positions are going to pan out before the finals. And make sure you subscribe to the SA Footballer magazine. Comes out every Thursday night, Friday morning. 180-odd pages of pure football genius. And we'll catch you again next week.